Hello and welcome to this special edition travel video. As you may be aware, I like to do travelogues from time to time on the channel lately. If you're not interested in this kind of thing, then please feel free to skip this video and my normal C++ weekly content will be back on Monday, just as it always is. This one is about a trip to California that I made this past year. So in April of 2024, my C++ travels took me and my family to Torrance, California. Torrance is a suburb on the south side of LA. It is easily accessible from LAX, being about a 25-minute drive, so that is the airport we flew into. We could have taken a bus, but that would have been over an hour. Now, if you're flying into LAX for the first time and looking for a rideshare, this airport is weird. You need to look for the shuttle signs that take you to the special rideshare lot. The shuttle takes maybe 10 minutes. It might actually be the same time to walk as you can cut across the lots, but I didn't try that. Your app will only let you book a ride after confirming that you have arrived in the rideshare lot. Well, that's a bit of an exaggeration. If you want to book a premium ride, such as Uber Black, then you can do that from the main terminal, but be prepared to spend about 2 times the price. Because of my work, I ended up staying in the Sonesta ES Suites Hotel. You know from my other travel videos that I always stay somewhere where we can do our own cooking, and this is no exception. I had a minimal but usable kitchen, and it was walking distance to a Trader Joe's as well as a few different breweries. I want to particularly give a shout out to the folks at Schulb Premium Ales for having a friendly and welcoming environment with a nice selection of beers. After 2 days of work, I had 1 day off, and we used that time to rent bikes and explore the coast of California. Now, just a quick aside as to the training aspect of this. In the United States, you're actually expected to file taxes in every state that you physically do work in, and California is particularly aggressive about this by actually requiring that the company you work for do withholding taxes from your contract labor. And this is unusual. I don't know of any other state that does this, but they definitely make sure that you file non-resident taxes in their state. The irony is not lost on me. This means it's actually more difficult for me to work within the United States than it is for me to work internationally because we don't have those international tax treaties that I mentioned before. Okay, so the concept was simple. We were going to walk to the bike rental shop, rent bikes, and head west out to the bike path, then go north to Santa Monica on the Marvin Broad Bike Trail, also known as the Beach Bike Path, the Coastal Bike Trail, the Strand, or the South Bay Bicycle Trail. There were a few minor problems with this otherwise simple concept. One, we were fortunate to get to the bike rental shop immediately after a bike had been returned, otherwise the entire plan would have failed. We didn't take into account how goofy the weather can be over here, which I will spend more time on later, and we underestimated the distance that we would be biking. Google's time estimates for the biking directions here assume that we were speeding almost the entire time. We legally could not have completed the ride in the time that Google said because of speed limits on the bike paths. And in fact, there were those speed signs to let you know if you were going too fast on the bike path. And most importantly, I feel while my family and I are fit and we had no difficulty with the cardio aspect of things, we're not used to sitting on bicycle seats for many hours at a time. So we rented our bikes from Torrance Bikes, and the people there were very friendly and helpful. And all told, we had spent $63 on 2 bikes plus a basket rental. The basket ended up being way more useful than we expected, so I do recommend that. The warm-up for getting used to the bikes and over to the bike path was a simple 2.3-mile downhill from Torrance Bikes to the Redondo Beach Pier. We were shocked to see the wall of fog when we got down to the beach level and felt the temperature plummet. This will be a theme for the rest of the ride. We locked the bikes up and wandered around the pier for a bit while looking for some warm clothing. My wife found a comfy hoodie to put over her existing hoodie, and we headed north, wishing we had also found gloves. Most of this southern bit of the trail was wide, flat, open beaches that are exactly what you think of when you think of beaches in California. There were even many public beach volleyball courts, and I thought I was right in the middle of California games or something. There was a cool and consistent wind, and we really could not see the ocean for the first several miles before hitting the area around the El Segunda power plant. The next 4 miles, about 20 minutes or so, felt particularly desolate and unpleasant in the fog while passing power plants, water treatment plants, the very busy LAX, and several homeless camps. The fog was thick enough that we couldn't see the airplanes at all, even though they were right over us. From the north side of LAX to the Santa Monica Pier was another 7.5 miles, which gets you up to Venice Beach. Upon reaching Balona Creek, the trail becomes more complicated to follow because you have to make your way around the Marina del Rey and back over to the beach. Once you do get back down to the beach, you are at the famous Venice Beach and things get a lot more interesting. There were a lot of people out doing all kinds of things, many shops and vendors, and if you're interested, you can go watch people work out. Before we continue up to the Santa Monica Pier, I would like to take a moment to recommend that you don't go to the Starbucks that's on the path at Marina del Rey. We were looking for a simple place to sit down, eat our packed snacks, and maybe get a warm drink, but no, the Starbucks does not have seats. Anyhow, this really was the most interesting part of the trip. The pier itself was rather busy, but we still couldn't see the ocean yet, and we were pretty cold by the time we got there. We spent some time wandering around finding various treats, including a Japanese-style hot dog stand that was definitely worth trying. At this point, we were rather tired and tired of being cold and sore from the bicycle seats, so we considered putting the bikes on a bus to make our way back down to Torrance. However, we really couldn't find any reasonable option, so we just sucked it up and headed back south. Fortunately, the sun finally decided to show itself and we got some warmth, and the trip back felt much faster. We stopped for groceries at the Torrance Whole Foods before dropping the bikes back off and just in the nick of time before closing. All told, I logged 2.5 miles of walking to and from the bike shop and about 38 miles of biking, and we were gone about 8.5 hours. Our final day in Torrance, we had the opportunity to go to the free and local Torrance Art Museum. They have a nice, relatively small selection of changing art from around the world. I highly recommend that you do stop by there if you get the chance. And I know that this is definitely a hidden little gem here because none of my students in Torrance had actually ever been to this art museum. So make sure you check it out if you're ever in the area. So thanks for watching this travelogue. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will catch you in the next episode.